Happy day two of the Masters, and last I checked, Tiger is plus two. He's had a rough day. Might make the cut for all you Masters fans out there, but yeah, not the most ideal of Fridays, but still a long ways to go. Anyway, I watch four golf tournaments a year. I'll let you figure out which ones they are. Spring practice, you know, reacting to Brent Venables' press conference today. And you know who Brent reminds me of? It just kind of hit me. You ever used to watch SNL in the 90s? And, you know, yeah, Chris Farley, he would play, what was it? Was it Mike Foley or Matt Foley? It was either, I think it was like Mike Foley, a motivational speaker, trying to, you don't want to end up living in a van down by the river. And I get that energy from Brent, but in an unironic, uncomedic type of way. He's trying to get this program that's going to go to the SEC in a couple years to make sure they don't end up in a van down by the river. Very important. There was a little bit of a misquote on Brent on Twitter today. I think it was an OU Daily person. I could be wrong. I'm not going to name names, but someone quoted him as saying, "We're going to the SEC next year." And my eyes opened up going, "Does he know something?" What he really said was, "We're going." He's like, "We're playing the Big 12 this year. We're playing the SEC in a couple years." And the message overall is to, and the message to the fan base of trying to fill this, we need to get ready for that. And as much as I love to come on here and talk about how much OU is a blue blood program, top five program all time, all the accolades, the truth of the matter is that we have not had the need for our fan base at inside the stadium to be loud for Oklahoma to win big games. It really hasn't been a necessity because, if we're being honest, like, there's maybe one game a year where a team walks in, if that, that has a legit shot to, like, go toe-to-toe to beat us if we don't just fall asleep like we did a lot last year. So, no, don't get me wrong. There are games we'll get excited for. We get excited for Bedlam. I'm sure the Nebraska game was fun last year for a lot of people. You know, in Tennessee and Notre Dame and Florida State. And I'm sure it'll get very loud when Georgia comes in about 18 months. But overall, he's right. You know, I think that's what he's trying to send that message. Like, we need to be a fan base that gets hyped up for the spring game. Now, do you need to be like the running of the gums and be obsessed with autographs and all that stuff and everything like that we used to make fun of on Twitter all the time? No. I'm not saying you need to do that. What I'm saying is like, he really, really wants to fill this stadium. They're really pushing it. And I'm waving the flag too. I was like, we need to get there. If I didn't live in Orlando and I could easily afford to hop on a flight that wasn't really expensive, I would go. I would be gone. I would join a couple of weeks. I've had people said, "I got a ticket for you." A ticket's not the problem. A ticket is the least expensive thing I'd be paying for. And I would have a place to stay and I would be able, that wouldn't be an issue either. It's just the fact that plane ticket's pretty expensive right now just to jump on and go round trip. Love to do it. But I'm going to be right here doing a watch along and it'll be fun. And you know, maybe I'll have something special along for that too. I'm trying to plan something, but no guarantees yet. I'm trying to work on something, but bare minimum doing a watch along for this spring game, which will be, I know Sooner Sports TV is doing it. If you pay, if you have like the seasonal thing, cause I use it to watch softball and stuff. So I know it's something I cover in every video. So if anyone asks, how do I watch the game? Well, I know how I'm watching it is through Sooner Sports TV. So that's one way. It probably will be on Bally Sports. Don't quote me on that. I think it will be. So just keep an eye out for that or one of the FS and or whatever they're called nowadays. But just some things he mentioned today. Woody Washington, he's saying, is being consistently like the best defensive back, which is not shocking at all. Typical bumps and bruises for some guys. You know, Trey Morrison's been in and out. He's working inside and outside in the secondary. I love hearing about Jordan Kelly. It feels like Jordan Kelly has been there forever. Like, I feel like Jordan Kelly has been there for 8 or 9 years. But I like hearing the good stuff on Jordan Kelly on defensive tackle. Jeffrey Johnson, the Tulane transfer. I'm from Brent and other places, I'm hearing he's doing really well. So, a defensive line. When you hear good things about the defensive line, that's always a positive. I've mentioned before, Javonte Barnes is looking great as a true freshman. The offensive line, you know, there's still work to do, but, you know, Brent's saying he's a good group. He likes the group. I know Andrew Rame's been dinged up before, still kind of working on the side with a boot, last I heard. But, and Dylan Gabriel is, he's a little streaky from what I understand, which, you know, you got to get the most out of it when you can. So, but he's a solid, you know, experienced college quarterback who's going to win you some games. So overall, it's just I feel like at times I'm repeating some of the same stuff. So whenever there's new information, it's just like, oh, God, certain defensive players are playing well. Like Woody Washington doing well in practice shouldn't shock anyone, but a lot of times he's been injured, so it's good to hear he's doing well in spring, and hopefully he can take another bigger step and have an even bigger impact on this season. So again, we are still a couple weeks away from the spring game. I feel like we're used to building up to it like a week from now, but not used to the later April date. But here we are. We still got more practices to go, and hopefully we will hear some more updates on recruiting. I know it's going to be a big recruiting weekend for Brett Venables, but everyone's waiting for commitments. And you know, again, it's the new regime. He's not going to take your commitment unless you shut down your recruiting if you're ready to commit. So, again, as I've said many, many times before already on the channel, it's a different world, different mindset, and we'll see how it turns out. I think it'll pay off in the end, but it's just got to be patient. I don't think we're going to get the regular commitment announcements that we really, really want to hear that really get us through the off season, especially me. It's like recruiting's like all the content I have from like May through July, August. It's like, please, I need some commitments for the channel, please. But thankfully, softball's kicking butt and taking names, and they will be playing Texas Tech this weekend, and I think they'll take care of them fairly easily. Get ready for Texas next week. That's the big series. So anyway, that's really all I got. Brent Venables, motivational speaker. He's pretty awesome. By the way, if you're in the press, I feel for you guys, the media scrum of whoever gets to ask a question, good for you, because God knows how long it'll take for him to answer. But I mean, it's good content, don't get me wrong, but I can relate a little bit. Just for the small little bit I've done some of this stuff. Someone gives a long, drawn out answer and you're still waiting, and then media time runs out. You're just out of luck. So if you got to ask a question, you got a good answer. Props to you. That's all I'm saying. Anyway, Boomer Sooner, I will catch you all later, and watch softballs on ESPN Plus all weekend. So check out the softball team. Later, guys.